Good afternoon. We start with breaking news. The assault case against Nick Kyrgios has been dismissed after the tennis star pleaded guilty to the charge. After trying to have the case thrown out on mental health grounds, the 27-year-old faced the ACT Magistrates Court this afternoon, admitting he shoved his ex-girlfriend during an argument outside her Canberra apartment in 2021. The magistrate saying the act was a one-off, not premeditated, happened some time ago, and was an example of a young man trying to get out of an emotional situation. Our reporter Ashley Wick is there. We'll take you to her live shortly. Well, a guide for the biggest overhaul of Medicare in a generation has been handed to state and territory leaders and the Prime Minister. Our political editor Charles Croucher is standing by for us in Canberra this afternoon. Charles, good afternoon. What will change?
Nothing right now, Davina, but there is a promise for change in the future. The premiers and chief ministers arrived today with the same priority, and that is an overhaul of the health system. They say, and so many people at home would know, that it is far too hard to see a GP, particularly one that bulk bills. And that's flowing on to the rest of the sector, with more Australians showing up in emergency departments and showing up sicker than they would be if they could see a GP. The first ministers were handed the Strengthening Medicare Task Force report. Among its recommendations, increasing access to bulk billing, longer consultations with GPs, and integrating nurses and pharmacists into the process, which would take pressure off GPs. The big sticking point will be funding. GPs say Medicare rebates will need to be increased drastically. For now, the Prime Minister says the focus is getting the model right.
People are turning up at emergency departments because they don't have other options. We need to improve primary health care. We need to improve access to GP services.
There is nothing in announcements today that is going to help a single Australian tomorrow.
So we'll hear more announcements and decisions in April with National Cabinet and then the budget in May. One thing the First Ministers did agree on, though, was supporting the Indigenous voice to Parliament, signing a statement of intent saying they will work together ahead of that planned referendum, Davina, which is later in the year.
Charles Croucher, live in Canberra. Thank you. Former Deputy Premier John Barilaro will avoid a criminal record for assaulting a cameraman in Manly last year. A magistrate dropping the charge on mental health grounds this afternoon, accepting Mr. Barilaro had recurrent depression, anxiety and PTSD, and that his life has been spiralling out of control after the death of his father, his resignation and the breakdown of his marriage. Our Chief Court Reporter Tiff Genders will have more coming up in the bulletin. Well, the Pentagon claims a spy balloon has been seen flying over the United States and they believe it belongs to the People's Republic of China. It's the size of about three buses with a technology base suspended underneath it, and they've been tracking it for a number of days, and we'll have more from our US correspondent Alison Petrowski coming up shortly in the bulletin. That security scare comes as America ramps up its military presence in Asia. Ali Petrowski filed this report.
With tensions escalating over Taiwan and the disputed South China Sea, this is essentially key real estate for the United States, giving them a front row seat to be able to monitor China. The US Secretary of Defense, Lloyd Austin, visiting the Philippines today, meeting with their president and defense minister, making this joint announcement where America will now have access to four more military bases in the Philippines. They can use them for joint training exercises, equipment storage, runways and fuel. They already had access to five other military bases, so this brings the total to nine. It's not clear yet which four bases they are referring to, but we know previously the US has expressed interest in the Cagayan province, the northernmost tip of the Philippines and a position closest to Taiwan and the Taiwan Strait.
We discussed concrete actions to address destabilizing activities in the waters surrounding the Philippines, including the West Philippine Sea. And we remain committed to strengthening our mutual capacities to resist armed attack.
Not everyone is happy about this deal. Filipino activists were gathered outside the military camp where Lloyd Austin's meeting was taking place, burning the US flag, voicing their displeasure over their country strengthening their military ties to the United States. While China's foreign ministry says this deal just hurts regional stability and escalates tensions further in the area.
A fresh barrage of missiles has ripped through eastern Ukraine. At least three people were killed when one of the strikes destroyed a residential building. 18 people are believed to be injured. 10 headstones at a cemetery in Maitland on the state's north coast have been vandalised with the Nazi symbol. Police are appealing for help from the public after finding the headstones damaged on Tuesday. They've seized a number of items and are urging anyone with information to contact Crime Stoppers. Fire and Rescue New South Wales is warning of the dangers of lithium batteries after a charging e-scooter sparked a fire at a unit block in Sydney's west. It happened just before midnight at a complex on Hoxton Park Road at Liverpool. Two people were assessed by paramedics but were not taken to hospital. Oil and gas giant Shell has made a record profit after the surge in energy prices. They're in the black, almost $56 billion, double last year's total and the highest in its 115-year history. The invasion of Ukraine has seen oil and gas prices jump substantially. Well, it's a tragic reminder today to every parent about the dangers of leaving children in hot cars. A three-year-old boy dying in Glenfield in Sydney's southwest yesterday, and it's not an isolated incident. Last month alone, 213 children were rescued across New South Wales and the ACT. That is the highest number in 5 years. Peter Currie from the NRMA joins us this afternoon. Peter, this is a grim statistic, each one preventable, each one could be a terrible tragedy. Why are these cases on the rise?
Yeah, look, horrible, statistics, horrible cases, and what we see, particularly in the heat, is they can lead to catastrophe pretty quickly. Now, NRMA patrols rescued 213 children last month. 2022 was the biggest month in biggest year in 10 years when you combine children and pets. So the statistics are not heading in the right direction. Now, the overwhelming majority of these cases are accidental. It's when mum or dad, you know, will accidentally lock the keys in the car or put the keys in the boot while they're putting the children in the car, and they call us, they call the NRMA, and we put those calls to the top of the list regardless of whether or not they're our members. But we have seen an increase in the last 12 months. COVID could be a factor in that parents were just not wanting to take children inside to shopping centres or supermarkets or wherever they were. We think weather might have been a factor because it was a cooler year, and so people were taking the risk. But whatever it is, there is no safe way to leave a child in the car, particularly in the middle of this heat.
What's your advice to parents when they're stuck in that situation then? Because you panic, don't you?
Yeah, look, if you've accidentally locked your children and child in the car, call us straight away. We see it a lot, as the statistics show. And when we get out there, often we spend more time trying to calm frantic parents than we do actually getting the child out of the car. So in those instances, we'll make sure we get there as quickly as we can. Don't panic. Obviously, when you're putting a child in the car, there are steps you can take. Keep your keys on you. We know it's frustrating and can be difficult when you're in the middle of a shopping centre car park, when it's busy, or when you're at the beach and people are there's lots of cars around. You want to get everything in the car as quickly as possible. But in those instances, it's really important just to keep your keys on you. But unfortunately, there are also some instances where children are left in a car. And in those cases, if you see a child locked in the car and if the child is distressed, don't wait. Break a window, get the child out of the vehicle as quickly as possible. Find the window that is furthest away from where the child is sitting. If the child isn't distressed, obviously call the police or the NRMA and we'll get that there as quickly as we can.
Well, there are no words for what happened yesterday. It was an absolute horrific tragedy. Our thoughts with that family. Peter, thank you so much for your time.